Okay, what if I told you that earwax is actually good for you? That sticky stuff that you think you need to get in there and clean out with a Q-tip might actually be protecting your ears. In fact, overly obsessing about cleaning your ears can cause more harm than good. Stick with me because at the end of this video, you'll know the truth about earwax, when to leave it alone, and how to take care of your ears safely. Hi everybody, my name's Ashley Agan. I'm a board certified ENT. Have you ever wondered, is it really that dangerous to put Q-tips in your ears? I'm just putting it just right here on the outside, I'm not pushing it in. Well, earwax is one of your body's natural defense systems. It's not gross, it's genius, okay? So hear me out here. What is earwax? Okay, earwax or cerumen, which is the medical term for it, it's a natural substance that your body makes inside the ear canal, and it's not just random gunk. It's a mixture of oils and skin cells, and it protects your ear canal. So think of it like a built-in cleaning system, keeps your ear canal moisturized, but it's also antibacterial, so it prevents you from getting ear infections. So why shouldn't you overclean? Here's the problem. Most people think earwax is dirty. Every day, everyone apologizes to me for having dirty ears going to the ENT. So here comes the famous Q-tip, and people feel like they're cleaning their ears. But when you push a Q-tip in your ear, you're actually pushing wax in against the eardrum and packing wax in. Your ears are self-cleaning, so you don't need to do that. Sometimes wax can become an issue. If you have ear pain, ringing, hearing loss, feeling like your ears are clogged and stuffy, you could have what we call impacted earwax, meaning it's been packed in there, usually from Q-tips. But certain groups are more prone to having wax buildup. These tend to be older adults, people who have hearing aids, people who have very small ear canals, or who have skin conditions like eczema. So what's a safe way to take care of your ears? For most of us, do nothing. Just let your ears be, leave them alone. If you are uncomfortable or if you build up wax, you can use over-the-counter drops that soften the wax naturally. You can use olive oil or coconut oil, but you never want to use any sort of instrument to scoop out wax. Let's do a little myth busting here. Okay, does ear candling work? Let's talk about ear candling. You may have seen this online or at spas. The idea is you put a hollow candle in your ear, you light up the end, and supposedly it creates a suction that's going to pull the wax out. Well, it doesn't. Studies have proven that no suction is generated, and what's even worse is that people have gotten burns or had hot wax drip, and so I personally recommend staying away from ear candling. It's not safe and it doesn't help. So when it comes to your ears, if you can, just leave them alone. And if you need someone to clean out your ears because you have small ear canals or because you have a skin condition leading to buildup of more wax, then go to an ENT who can take a look with a microscope and clean it out safely. Don't use Q-tips. And earwax is not dirty. It's natural. So as we wrap this up, if you think this episode helped you rethink wax, then do me a favor. Share it with that friend or family member who just can't live without their Q-tips. And don't forget to subscribe. I've got new ear, nose, and throat videos coming out weekly. And if there's a topic that you've just been dying to know more about, let me know in the comments below. And if you are looking for an ENT doctor to work with, check us out. We're here in Dallas, Texas, but we see patients from all over the country. You can find us at scottyent.com. You can book your appointment online, or you can book a virtual meet and greet where we can jump on a virtual call and kind of see if we are a good fit.